Born in St. Joseph, Michigan, to Bill and Wilma Graw, Jim was raised in Michigan with his sister Mary Helen. He earned a Bachelor of Science degree in chemistry from Antioch College in Ohio, where he served as the Antioch Community Manager. After college, he attended Syracuse University from 1939 to 1941 and earned his Master of Science degree in Public Administration. Upon graduation, he was a personnel officer with TVA in Knoxville, Tennessee. In 1942, he joined the U.S. Navy Reserve, where he served on three destroyer escorts as a gunnery officer and later as executive officer. His commission lasted until 1946. Jim was married in 1946 to his wife, Eleanor. Jim credits Eleanor with being his principal source of advice, reassurance, and persuasion in taking the job with Basin Electric. Jim and Eleanor have two sons, David and Bart. Eleanor passed away in 1994. After leaving the Navy, Jim worked with the Office of Management and Budget as Organization and Management Specialist, and later as a Budget Analyst in the nuclear power area. In 1955, he became the Assistant General Manager and Director of Atomic Energy Service for the American Public Power Association in Washington, D.C. In June of 1962, Jim became the first employee and General Manager of Basin Electric Power Cooperative. His office was only a rented room, a card table, and a few folding chairs. But within 10 years, construction on Basin's headquarters building began. It was built into a hill with windows facing southeast to take advantage of natural sunlight to conserve energy. Within 1 year, Basin Electric's first generating unit, a 210,000 kilowatt lignite fueled unit, had its groundbreaking ceremony in Stanton, North Dakota. This was no small feat, considering that the REA had placed numerous stop orders on the loan Basin was depending on. Nonetheless, Leland Old Station Unit 1 was built on schedule and below budget. And Jim Graw and Basin Electric didn't stop at just supplying energy. Under Jim's leadership, Basin Electric was a pioneer in protecting the environment and managing socioeconomic impacts associated with power plant construction. In fact, in the mid-1960s, Basin Electric proposed model laws to the North Dakota legislature to protect the air, water, and land. Jim worked closely with State Farmers Union to organize rural water co-ops and to promote legislation that required the reclamation of coal fields. At that time, Jim and Basin Electric made their peers in the power industry very angry by advocating these policies. Jim was so dedicated to the environment and preserving the serenity of the plains that he even went so far as to insist that the power plants be painted pale blue with soft white trim to blend in with the open blue skies and clouds. In 1980, on behalf of Basin Electric, Jim accepted the Award for Excellence in Pollution Control from President Carter's Council on Environmental Quality. Also under Jim's leadership, Basin Electric initiated the People's Housing Program to help relieve the critical shortage of adequate rural housing. More than 2,000 new housing units were built as a result. Jim was also instrumental in forming the Missouri Basin Power Project, a group of six consumer-owned utilities that developed the Laramie River Station in Wyoming. Nationally, he was active with the APPA, NRECA, and was one of the founding members of Western Fuels Association, the nation's first fuels cooperative. Through it all, Jim had time to devote to his wife and children. Family vacations to places such as Lake Louise in the Canadian Rockies and Captiva Island in Florida were especially valued. Jim retired in 1985 with his wife Eleanor to their home in Fairfax County, Virginia. He has remained committed to cooperatives. He received the Nikola Tesla Award and Distinguished Service Awards from NRECA and APPA. And in 1992, he was inducted into the North Dakota Entrepreneurs Hall of Fame. Jim managed Basin Electric when it was experiencing rapid growth. Starting with a handful of employees in the early 1960s and $2 million in assets, Basin Electric grew to a $3 billion organization with nearly 1,300 employees in 1985 when he retired. Jim Graw's words and deeds have demonstrated statesmanship, innovation, personal commitment, leadership, and vision. His actions have achieved identifiable and lasting changes to improve and promote cooperatives. And he has inspired others to advance the cooperative system. We are proud to honor him here tonight.